Hello, beautiful internet family, Danny from DansTube.TV, and on today's video, we're going to find out if the DJI FPV drone can be used as a cinematic drone to add some unique perspectives to your videos. If you're new around these parts, then you can expect brutally honest tech reviews on the channel. And I've made it my mission to help tech enthusiasts unlock their creative potential with technology. And like I said, we're checking out the DJI FPV drone. This is actually a loan unit from the D1 store. I actually do have a 10% discount, so then you can save some dollary dues on your drones, accessories, and cameras. The code is MMAFB. It stands for Mavic Mini Australia Facebook. Just MMAFB. Save 10%, it's quite big when you're purchasing a drone. So basically I realized that I can't fly FPV, so what am I gonna do with this really fun drone here? What can I do? And I decided let's create a video and try to make it look cinematic. Let's find out whether the FPV drone can be used by filmmakers as a cinematic alternative. So just in terms of logistics, I guess, the battery life on this thing, not fantastic. So you've got a major limitation there where you could be using a cinematic drone. I'm probably only getting like 15 minutes, maybe, depends on how I'm flying, but 15 minutes out of this drone from one battery is not fantastic. You really need to know what you're gonna be capturing before you go and capture it. You can see on the front there that it is a 4K camera and it can shoot 60 frames per second. So you'll see some footage pop up now, and this is just from the camera itself. You can see it's not the most stable footage in the world. It's quite jumpy and bumpy and a bit funky, which I don't know about. But it also just isn't the most crispy footage in the world. Like, it's a really nice camera, but I guess if we're comparing it to a cinematic drone, you're obviously better getting a cinematic drone for the purpose of creating a film. But if you want that unique perspective, if you want something a bit more, you know, dynamic and fast moving, then, you know, all we've got to do here is we've got to crop the image in a little bit to cut out those propellers and then put some stabilization on it, and you can get some unique cinematic shots from this guy here. Yeah, you're going to be changing batteries pretty frequently, but if you've got an idea of what you want to shoot, you can get some super unique perspectives here, and it's a lot faster than those cinematic drones. And the way it banks and moves, it just feels a lot more unique, and it will add a unique perspective to your cinematic shots. The other interesting thing is that you get to wear these goggles. And it's interesting because you have to have a cable, you have to have a little power bank that you have in your pocket, and that's how the headset is powered. Now, I would have liked to have seen the power bank to be a little bit larger so that you could actually charge the drone battery as well. You know, like, this is nice, it's compact, it does its job for the headset, but it would be really cool if you could have a fly and then have a larger battery, so you would unplug it or you'd have an attachment piece, plug it into the drone's battery, and then just do whatever you've got to do while it's charging. That would make the world of difference, because you're getting like a few flights out of this for the headset, for the most part from my experiences, but why not make it a little bit bigger and then make it a little bit more practical? Because it's just quite limited. Like, if you don't have multiple batteries, you've got to be really clear on the shots you're getting. And then the other limitation is the range. I found that I didn't get the most amazing range. And again, if you get a standalone cinematic drone, like an Air 2S or a Mavic 2 Pro, or, you know, even a Mavic Mini, you're going to be getting a more cinematic experience. You're going to get a lot more range out of it, and the battery life is going to be significantly better. So obviously they are geared more towards what you're looking for. But I guess the thing that's really cool about having something that's this unique is that, you know, a lot of drone shots have become quite, you know, predictable and stagnant. It's just out there. Everyone knows what a drone shot looks like now, where FPV is still kind of a relatively kind of new thing to the mainstream. Like, yes, it's been around for years and there've been FPV shots all over, but to the real mainstream, it's just not as common. So some of the footage you can see overlapped here. I really like those low banking shots near the grass. I really love those nice, you know, fast shots as I'm going up that dirt trail and I get nice and close to the ground there. I think that's really unique, and you can't get the exact same feel from a cinematic drone. So that does add a different layer to it, and it doesn't feel like a standalone cinematic experience. Like, it doesn't feel like a Mavic Mini or a Mavic Air or a Mavic Pro. It feels like a unique FPV experience. And I think if you splice that kind of footage in with your other cinematic shots or with some B-roll you've got on the ground, it does add a unique perspective and it does stand out over the competition. So I think if you crop in so you lose those propellers and you put some stabilization on the footage, it actually does add a really unique cinematic perspective where you can't get that same kind of feel from other drones. So I think DJI have done something really cool here because, you know, to get into that FPV mode, to get into that manual mode is a whole process. And they've locked that out so that only FPV pilots can fly that way. And I guess I was thinking, like, you know, what can I do as a cinematic kind of drone pilot? You know, like, I'm not going to fly FPV. I don't want to give it to someone else because it's a loan unit. I don't want to damage it. But how can I make this a unique perspective? And I guess there are a lot of people in the same boat as me who don't fly FPV, but are probably really interested by the design of it and interested with, you know, what they could actually get from a drone of this size, this shape, and this form. And it really does fly completely differently. So it's exhilarating to get those shots. And like I said, if you take the two drones out, this one and a cinematic drone, and you just use them for a solid 30 minutes, you know, let's say 15 minutes on here, 15 minutes on your cinematic drone, you're gonna have a lot of unique footage then to cut in with some of your other B-roll. And I think that's where it really stands out as a complementary addition to your filmmaking. Like you can see from the footage, it's really unique and really cool, but there are some major limitations to it. And it's clearly not geared towards a cinematic experience. It's more so that FPV experience to give you that raw movement in the sky. I will have my full review on the DJI FPV drone as well. And it'll be coming from the perspective of like a commercial drone pilot, someone who, you know, does commercial jobs, is kind of in that filmmaking space with the YouTube side of things, but just doesn't fly FPV. Because I think, you know, a lot of the FPV reviews I've seen are from people who fly FPV. And there's definitely people out there who are interested in this, but maybe don't have the knowledge of how to fly FPV. So check out that video, that will be up on the channel very soon. And I think overall, yes, you can create a very cinematic, unique perspective from this guy. But the other thing I forgot to mention a bit earlier on is it makes a completely different sound. Like, dogs react to it, people look at it. It's a statement piece, where a lot of the other drones now kind of blend into the, you know, societal noises that we're used to. Like, drones just aren't that crazy anymore. But this guy makes a crazy sound and people do look. So that's another thing. If you want to create something cinematic, you're going to be turning a lot of heads with this thing, so that might not be a good thing. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I'd love your thoughts in the comments below. Do you think this adds an additional cinematic layer to your footage? Is this something you're interested in, or is it just completely off your radar and you're sticking to the cinematic world? That's it, guys. Have a great one. Talk to you soon.